Hey my fellow follicle frontiersmen, DJ back from Keratin Brotherhood. Welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm gonna be talking to you guys about the minoxidil shed. Now, the minoxidil shed is a real thing. I don't think a lot of people talk about it enough. And because of that, a lot of guys, when they start minoxidil for the first time and they start noticing their hair falling out, which is the complete opposite effect of what you expect from minoxidil, they freak out and they quit using minoxidil. Or they go to the message boards and, you know, drop comments about, you know, this is bullshit. You guys lied to me. What am I gonna do? My life is over. Oh my God. And I think, you know, a little bit of misinformation is causing a lot of these problems. So what I'm gonna do is talk about the shedding and why it's normal. I just took a shower. My hair is still wet, actually. I got water in my hair. I don't have any concealer in right now, and I do have a very big fluorescent light shining on the top of my head. If I step back, my hair is not that thin. All right, I did have hair transplant surgery back in 2014, only on the front here, 5,000 hairs. I did not have any hairs transplanted in my crown. I was completely bald. I think I was like Norwood 6 or 7. So this is me without any concealer. And I've been on minoxidil for about 4 years now, religiously. And because I've been on minoxidil 4 years, I have experienced shedding phases probably once every 2 months. You'll start noticing a few hairs falling out. If I rub my hair right now, I can, yeah, here's one here. You can, well, of course you guys can't see that, but it's a hair there. You'll start having these hairs fall out. And these are just like 5 or 10 hairs. You'll just notice it, like when you rub your hand through, you'll start noticing that there's hairs. There's one right there, see it? There's hairs on your finger. If you watched my previous video, I'll link it here where I talk about how minoxidil works. The minoxidil speeds up the hair process, or the hair cycle rather, which means that any hairs that you had before, if they were close to the end of the stage of life, they would fall out. Coupled with that, a lot of the hairs that were dormant, the minoxidil will kind of wake the follicles back up and then they start growing. But as they grow, there's still gonna be very thin hairs, and so those hairs have to fall out. And the goal is, or the hope is rather, that they come back thicker than before. So you take the hairs that were almost dead at the end of their life cycle, plus the hairs that are too thin and have to fall out in order for the thicker hairs to come back. And what ends up happening is this perfect storm of guys, when they first start using minoxidil, is they get the handful of hair and then they think that their life is over and that the minoxidil is one big sham. And that couldn't be further from the truth. Okay, so first thing, guys, understand minoxidil, you're going to shed. And it's gonna be a continuous shed. All right, you're gonna be at different stages of shedding throughout the whole time that you're using it. I've been using it for 4 years now, and I was freaked out at the beginning. And I even still get freaked out, you know, these days, especially right now, which brings me to my next topic. Every shed is not the same. All right, all sheds are not created equal. And like I said, every 2 months or so, you get this little baby shed where you like 5 or 10 hairs daily, or maybe weekly, and then it kind of tapers off and you can continue with your day. But probably once every 5 or 6 months, you get what I like to call the big one. And right now I am almost at the end of the big one. For the past week, I have been shedding like a fucking golden retriever. Dude, I'm talking about like hairs everywhere. And most of the hairs are vellus. They're, like I said, really thin hairs, like this one here. There's really thin hairs that we're gonna fall out anyways. And so the normal growth cycle, you have to get rid of those hairs first. It just so happens that because every hair grows at a different rate, some of the hairs that start growing when you first started using minoxidil kind of follow the same time period, which means that it's possible for all of those hairs that started together to fall out together. And that's what I call the big one. So we can take a look here. You can see that I have lost hell a lot of density here. I'll put the video here, link here. You can see I usually have really good density, and this is just from minoxidil. I usually have really good density here from using minoxidil. I don't use finasteride. I don't use any of those other medicines except for minoxidil. No hair just transplanted here. It was completely bald, but I had pretty good density. But right now I'm at the end of one of those big shedding phases, and so my head has gone kind of bald again. There's still the thick terminal hairs here, but it's significantly thinner than it was before. I just want you guys to understand that, you know, you're gonna shed, guys, and it's gonna be scary because hair is a sensitive thing for us. I mean, that's why you're watching this video, because you're probably looking to hear from some guys that are experiencing the same that you have been experiencing. If you have any more questions or if you have any ideas for things you'd like to see in my videos, drop it down below, subscribe to the channel, and then leave a like. See you guys next time. Bye.